गुड आफ्टरनून. कंटिन्यूइंग विद द प्रीवियस पार्ट ऑफ द स्टोरी द टाइगर किंग. द टाइगर किंग वॉज रेडीड फॉर मैरिज, राइट. नाउ द स्टैटिस्टिक्स वेर ड्रॉन एंड इट वॉज कंक्लूडेड विच प्रिंसेस वॉज मोस्ट सूटेबल डिपेंडिंग ऑन द नंबर ऑफ टाइगर्स इन हर किंगडम फॉर द टाइगर किंग. Now finally a princess was chosen and the tiger king got married. Now whenever he visited his father-in-law, he used to kill 3 or 4 or 5 tigers each time he went to his in-law's house. Now this tiger king, he had 99 tigers adorning his wall, right? The skins of the tigers decorated on his walls. So he had killed 99 tigers. There was only one tiger remaining to fulfill the astrologer's prediction, right? He was determined to kill 100 tigers. So he had killed 99 and this was the 100th tiger which he was searching to be killed. Now everywhere in his kingdom, in his father-in-law's kingdom, all the tigers had died. So there was no tiger left. But he wanted to kill. So he proclaimed anyone who would find the tiger would be rewarded. But everyone said, it is easier to find a tiger's milk than a live tiger. Why? Because tiger's milk is not possible to find. But tiger's milk can be found. Tiger, live tiger could not be found. So it was a very tough job to find a tiger. Okay? But once what happened, the sheep around the village, one of his villages, it started disappearing. People feared that there was a tiger in the forest who comes and takes those sheep every day. So he was very happy, but he said that we must ascertain, we must make sure that it is a tiger. Not the two people named Khadir Milan Sahib or Virasmani Naikar. These two people are voracious eaters and they can eat a sheep at a time. So whether it is those people taking away the sheep for their dinner or the tiger. So it was ascertained and they were sure that it was the tiger who was taking away the sheep. The villagers informed the Maharaja and Maharaja was so happy that 3-year exemption of the tax was given to the village, right? He gave 3 years tax exemption to the villagers. Now everything was arranged. They were all ready to go. Now they did not find the tiger. When they reached the village, they did not find the tiger. It was very difficult for them to find the tiger. Now the Maharaja started getting angry. And in his anger, he said, now double the tax of the people. The Diwan said that the people will become discontented, right? And then they will tell the Indian National Congress to take over the kingdom. He said that in case you can go, you may resign and go, but I will not allow the people to live like this without giving me the tiger that they had promised. Now the Diwan was very much worried because he would lose his job if the kingdom goes to Indian National Congress, right? So he came home. Now in Diwan's home, there was a tiger hidden. He had brought it from the People's Park in Madras and hidden it in his home. It was a very old tiger. So he thought that he would take this tiger for the king to hunt. So at midnight, when everything was peaceful, he and his wife, both of them were aged, they dragged the tiger out, okay, and pushed the tiger into the car. Now the car reached the forest. The Maharaja was ready for hunting, but there was no tiger. And when they reached the, when Diwan and his wife reached the forest with the tiger in the car, they opened the gate and they thought that the tiger would come out. But the tiger had launched the satyagraha, right? He was not ready to come out of the car. Now both of them, the Diwan and his wife, both of them were aged, but still they hauled the tiger to come out of the car. They pushed him, and both of them pushed him out of the car. Now the tiger was in the forest. Next day, the old tiger wandered about in the Maharaja's presence, where the Maharaja was camping. He came in front of him and he stood there as if in supplication, in resignation, waiting for the orders from the Maharaja. What I have to do, Maharaja? What do you command me to do? Now the Maharaja was so happy that he took out his gun and he aimed at the beast, that is the tiger. The tiger fell down. Okay? He was very happy. The king was very happy. I have killed the 100th tiger. He had fulfilled his vow of killing 100 tigers. Now he ordered the officials to bring the tiger to the city, right, in a procession. And the king left in a car. He went back to the palace. Now after the Maharaja left, the hunter went near the tiger to pick him up and take in the procession. When the hunters reached near the tiger opened his eyes in surprise and looked, rolled his eyes and looked into the eyes of the hunters. Now the hunters were surprised because the tiger had not died. Okay, he was afraid of the bullet shot which missed him and he had fainted, right? He did not die. So the hunters thought if they call back the tiger king, they would be punished. So what they did was that they shot the 100th tiger, right? So the tiger king did not kill the 100th live tiger. It was the hunters who had killed the tiger. And the tiger was brought in a grand procession to the palace and it was buried. A tomb was erected over it with all the respect towards the 100th tiger. Everyone was happy. No one knew the fact except the hunters, right? Now the king was also very happy. He had delayed everything, all the work, because he had concentrated on killing the tiger, right? So he was now engaged in his work. Now few days later, it was his son's third birthday, right? His son was 3 years old. So he was trying to celebrate the birthday in a very lavish, in a very grand way. And he thought that now he would give some time to his son. So he went to the shopping center to purchase some gift for his 3-year-old son. He could not find anything suitable to give it to his son. On one shop, he saw there was a wooden tiger, right? And he thought that this is going to be the perfect gift for my son. So he bought that wooden tiger. He asked the shopkeeper what the price was. The price of the wooden tiger was 2 annas and a quarter, right? 2 annas and a quarter is there are 16 annas in a rupee, right? This was the earlier currency before the independence. 16 annas in a rupee, right? And the price of the wooden tiger was 2 annas and a quarter, quarter of a anna. So the shopkeeper thought that if I tell him that this wooden tiger is only 2 annas and a quarter, he is going to be punished under the rules of emergency. So he said that, Maharaja, this is a very rare piece, a very perfect piece of craftsmanship. A very special person has carved out this wooden tiger, and if I give it to you at a bargain rate, it is going to be 300 rupees, right? So he quoted the price as 300 rupees. The actual price of this wooden tiger was 2 annas and a quarter, but he quoted it at 300 rupees. So the king said, okay, very good, let this be a gift to the prince from your side. There was no problem to the shopkeeper because it was very cheap, but he had quoted a very high price. So he gave it to the king. The king brought it and he played with his son. Both the father and son were playing with the wooden tiger. Now you can imagine the wooden tiger, which cost only 2 annas and a quarter, must have been carved by a very unskilled carpenter, right? It was very raw, right? It was very rough. The tiny slivers of wood, they were on the surface of the wooden tiger. It was all over, just like quills, right? Very sharp. So one of those slivers, it pierced the Maharaja's right hand. So he pulled it out with the left hand and continued to play with his son. Next day, the infection flared up, right? And there was pus formation in that wound. And from the fingers, it spread all over his arm, right? It had become sore, right? So there was pus formation and it was a very big sore. His right hand was affected. So 3 famous surgeons from Madras were brought, and they decided that the Maharaja should be operated upon. So the surgeons took the king into the operation theater, and they carried out the operation. And when they came out, they said, the operation is successful, the Maharaja is dead. The operation is successful, the Maharaja is dead. So the 100th tiger killed him. The 100th tiger was the wooden tiger. The surgeons said the operation was successful, the Maharaja is dead. The operation was successful, the Maharaja is dead. It is actually a satire, right? The king wanted to kill 100th tiger, but the prediction of the astrologer proved to be right. Right? He was killed by the 100th tiger, and that 100th tiger was not a live tiger, but it was the wooden tiger. Right? Now this story is humor as well as a satire on the conceit of those in power, because they are so proudy, right? They think that they can achieve anything. They can overpower even death, right? Here, the king tries to prove the astrologers wrong. The astrologers had predicted that he would die of killed by the tiger, right? But he did not listen to the caution of the astrologers. Instead, he started killing the tigers, right? And in the end, he was killed not by the live tiger but by the wooden tiger. Okay, so tiger had taken its toll, but not the live tiger but the wooden tiger. Okay, there is also you can say the killing of the animals, right? The irony is that the name of the kingdom is Pratibandhpuram and there are killing of the tigers. Okay, this is the irony. Okay, and here the animals, the innocent animals are killed just to protect the life of the king, right? He did not accept the destiny. He should have thought, let the death come whenever it comes, right? But he tries to prove that he is far more superior and he can overpower the death, and in this way he killed innocent tigers, right? Here there is also one important aspect about the behavior of the people surrounding the king, the people who were working under the king, right? They were also fearsome. They were also just obeying whatever the king said. Firstly, when the king, the astrologer, he predicted his death, right? He was afraid to say. But when the king said, okay, speak up without fear, he said that you may kill 99 tigers, but you won't be able to kill the 100th tiger. The ministers were there who did not stop him from killing the innocent tigers. Instead, they searched for tigers in the kingdom and also searched a princess belonging to a kingdom where there were more tigers, right? There was also a group of hunters who had gone with the king to the woods to kill the 100th tiger. They were also not loyal, right? They just killed the 100th tiger who was not shot by the king. They killed that 100th tiger out of fear that if they inform the king that the tiger has not been shot at, they would be punished, right? Then there is another person, the shopkeeper, who sold the unfinished toy at a very high cost for the fear of being punished, right? Okay, so there are these people who surround the king, the tiger king, who just speak in favor of the king, who just work in favor of the king out of fear, or out of being fear of being punished or losing their job. So there are many things which people did which motivated this tiger king to kill the 100 tigers. So this story ends with the irony that the tiger king, who was named tiger king because he killed so many tigers, right, was killed by a wooden tiger, not a live tiger. Okay, thank you.